Hey guys, doing this is Zach again. Today's do-it-yourself video, I'm going to show you how to replace the control arms on your E46 all-wheel drive 3 Series BMW. First, jack up and support the car, then remove the lug nuts, then remove the wheel. First, using a 19mm open-ended box wrench, remove the outer ball joint nut as far as you can. Next, using a tie rod separator, or a pickle fork as I call it, we're going to remove the outer ball joint from the steering knuckle. Try to use a heavy-handed hammer, as it'll make this a lot easier. So as you can see that a normal socket and socket wrench is too tall to fit this location from the front or from the back. And normally you would have to remove the subframe bolts, lower the subframe a few inches to get access to these bolts. This is why I love using these adjustable ratcheting open-ended wrenches that have a swivel at the end. What this allows is for me to get behind the bolt and swivel and ratchet just enough to remove the bolt without needing to remove the subframe. So coming from the back side, I'm going to attach my box wrench. Now, using an open-ended 18mm wrench, we're going to remove the inner ball joint from the subframe, and then the other bolt on the right-hand side. Don't be worried that you can't pull the bolt out the whole way, because we've removed the outer ball joint and the lower control arm bushing from the car. So now you can remove the entire control arm off the subframe. Since we need to reuse the lollipop or the lower control arm bushing bracket, we need to pull the old bushing off the control arm and then press out the old bushing and press in the new one. So the first step, I'm going to use some lubricant on the back, and then I'm going to use a 3-jaw puller. You can rent this tool at just about any hardware store. I'm going to use a 16mm socket to tighten down the push rod on this puller. And you can see as I tighten this down, it's going to start pulling the old bushing off. Now you can remove the 3-arm puller. I'll finish pulling the bushing off the control arm. Before we press out the old bushing, two things you want to note. One is the distance that the bushing has been pushed through the lollipop, the control arm bushing bracket, on either side. You want to make sure that when you push the new bushing in, it's identical to the way that you pushed it out. Number two, you want to make sure that the little alignment mark inside the old bushing is lined up to the lower control arm bushing bracket. So you can see when we go to put the new bushing in, we want to make sure that it's lined up in exactly the same orientation. You can use a bench vise to press in and out the old and new bushings. I'm lucky enough to have access to a press here, and if you don't have either one of these, you can always go to a machine shop, and I'm sure they'll be pretty happy to do this for you. So I'll set this up. So, to push the new bushing in and finish pushing out the old bushing, I'm going to make sure that the alignment tabs are correct. So I'm going to follow this line, the line of the new bushing, and set the bushing in the press. Align everything. So with a new bushing, halfway pushed in, the alignment tabs are still good to go. I want to make sure that I'm only pushing the bushing in as far as the previous bushing was, so you can see how much distance we still have to cover with the press here. So we've got the new bushing pushed into the lollipop, so now we're going to go reinstall it onto the control arm. So now with the bushing pressed into the lower control arm bushing bracket, I've added a little bit of hand washing detergent. You don't want to use any type of penetrating oil or petroleum-based lubricant to push the bushing onto the end of the control arm, because that'll actually degrade the rubber and eat it from the inside. So what we're going to do now, like I said, put a little soap on the inside. I'm going to put the bushing onto the back of the control arm. And what we're going to do is preload the bushing. So preloading the bushing means you don't want to put the bushing on the control arm in the wrong orientation and have that rubber set around that control arm. And then when you go to bolt it in the car, it's going to be impossible. But not only that, it's going to make the bushing wear out faster. So we're going to get the bushing onto the control arm. To do that, I'm going to use my friend here, this heavy hammer. And I'm going to hit the inner race, which is going to push the bushing onto the control arm. Just like that. All right. Now this control arm is ready to go back in the car. Now we're going to install the inner ball joint. I'm going to thread the bolt through on one side, slide it into the subframe, and then tighten these down with an 18 millimeter. I like to put a little dab of anti-seize on these lower control arm bushing bracket bolts, just because they're so prone to rust. I know that my car has over 200,000 miles on it, but you never know if and when you'll ever have to replace your control arms ever again, and you'll be thanking yourself for adding that anti-seize on there. Now, let's reinstall the new control arm into the car. I'm going to do the center ball joint first. Gives you a little bit more flexibility when putting this back on. So I'm going to slide it on the ball joint. Just hand tighten the retaining screw down. Now you can see the benefit of attaching the inner ball joint first. It supports the weight of the control arm while you maneuver the entire control arm and the bracket back into place. Then you can reinstall your retaining screws and tighten them down. Next, we're going to install the outer ball joint into the steering knuckle. You can see here that we used a floor jack to push up on the lower control arm into the knuckle, just to wedge the ball joint a little bit better and to keep the whole ball joint itself from spinning as you tighten it down. Now, a lot of people don't have torque wrenches, and for this particular location, you can't use a torque wrench to tighten it down. So the specifications call for about 48 pound-feet of torque for this, which is about half of what it takes to tighten your lug nuts, just for a point of reference. Lastly, we're going to tighten down the inner ball joint retaining nut with a 22 millimeter wrench. And that's it. That's all it takes to replace the front control arms in your all-wheel drive E46 3 Series BMW. Now this process is similar to an E36 or even an E30 control arm replacement. A lot of the steps are the same. Thank you very much for watching. See you guys.